is Auntie Hammy Time.
Where my nieces?
Boop, 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 bow.
Where my nephews?
Let's rock out.
Bow, bow, bow.
Something came from Baltimore, Baltimore, Baltimore. Something came from Baltimore, Baltimore, Baltimore.
Internet has a superstar. Comedian Auntie Hammy is burning up the internet with It's a 22 recording last year with a big old hit, Pew Pew Pew.
Hold up, wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew Pew Pew. Pew Pew Pew. Hold up, wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew Pew Pew. Pew Pew Pew.
Like Eddie Murphy, Auntie Hammy is a comedian who sings, but the difference between the two is that Auntie Hammy's tracks are banging. Forget the double entendres and the spirit of LaWaya Page. Auntie Hammy is putting it all out there, raw, like Blowfly, and it's a hit. Legions of devoted fans known as nephew nieces are way into her sex-positive vagina spirit. Auntie Hammy comedian Caravan is rolling into Baltimore, where she'll be performing at the Ibis Lounge on Sunday, July the 7th. And this may be the first time that you can catch a comedian and prefer to stand and dance the whole way through. Auntie Hammy is hanging here for the weekend of the 4th, and she is cooking and hanging out with all her nephews and nieces. It's a family affair, and we're going to learn more about that. Auntie Hammy, welcome to Something Came From Baltimore.
Hey, what's up?
We're very excited to have you over here in Baltimore. You're going to be here on the July the 4th weekend. You have a little party going on, and you're at a Ibis Lounge?
Yes, yes. I'll be there. I'm having a comedy concert, and I'm getting it lit in Baltimore.
Good. We can't wait to see you. I have never seen a comedian who really demands that their audience get up and, you know, shake their butts along with you. What could someone expect when they go to one of your concerts?
Well, it's high energy, lots of funny songs, and I do twerk boot camp where I'll be twerking and then I'll get in your face and say, hey, get your ass up and start twerking your ass. So, you know, I get all into it. It's similar to like a skit that I'm doing, and I have the audience participate.
I'm someone who obviously I can keep rhythm, but when it comes to the twerking part, somehow there's a bone I think that was missing back there that doesn't allow me to twerk to the level of competence. So I think I'd be one of your people that you would be at least making fun of.
Right, right. I tell you to wiggle like you're on the toilet and you don't have any toilet paper left. So, you know, you can just wiggle as if you're just trying to, you know, wiggle your penis to get the piss off.
I've done that before. That's baby twerking.
Yes. That means you've twerked before. You got the moves. You just do it to the beat, and there you go.
Now, you are Nicole Hunter, but your character is Auntie Hammy. How long have you been in the comedy world?
2 years.
What were you doing before that that made you decide to go into comedy?
I was in the corporate world, 9 to 5. I worked in banking, and then I was a college professor, and then worked for a actual school. I was doing college in intermission at a school as well, and then I decided, hey, I want to become a comedian. I was on a line and got a lot of people that were interested. I would jump up and down in my town, and Facebook started paying people to go live. And I said, hey, I can make a living off of this. And 2 years later, here I am.
Do you have people from your past and you're like screaming, Eiffel Tower, Eiffel Tower? Are they blowing their minds that they met you when?
Eiffel Tower, Eiffel Tower, got the pussy standing high like Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, they are just, they, the people that knew me before the whole comedy thing, they are pretty shocked about my comedy. They love it, but they were just very shocked because it's very different from my actual self.
And your past, yeah, definitely.
Right. My alter ego.
When I was, doing a review, I was trying to explain people in my job who you were. And I said, she is a cross between LaWanda Page.
You are a heathen. That's what you are, a heathen. You are no good heathen. And you're going to pay for your sins one of these days, you miserable old bug.
And Blowfly, and they looked at me and said, who's LaWanda Page and Blowfly? And we know who that LaWanda Page is, someone who is considered one of your, comedian idols.
Yes, that's I love LaWanda Page. My actual name is LaWanda Nicole Hunter. So I love Sanford and Sons and Auntie Esther. So that's where I get the Auntie Hammy character from. So yeah, I really, really enjoy LaWanda Page. I was able to listen to her vinyls, and they are excellent. They're hilarious.
And how did you come up with one of my favorite songs, the Pew 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 song?
Wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew pew pew. Pew pew pew.
Oh yeah, it's a joke that it stems from me doing my shows nightly. I would say, hey, you guys don't argue with your significant other. You can just shoot them. You turn your vagina into a pistol, and you just shoot them up, and then he won't, be fussing anymore. So, it was a funny little joke. And I wanted to describe different types. So, I would say smaller ones were 22s and larger ones were choppers. Older ones were 45s. It just was a joke that I did every night. And one day someone shared it and it started going viral. Snoop Dogg shared it.
And what is yours? Is it a 22 or is it a chopper?
I say I have a chopper.
Your chopper.
It's huge. It's humongous.
It seems you're very pro-vagina. Like there's a lot of talking about it. You got the Persian rug.
The magic carpet back. That motherfucker back. You can see it. You can tell by my edges. That motherfucker back. Harry Pussy is a magic carpet. Harry Pussy is a magic carpet. Harry Pussy, yeah, you wanna ride it. Harry Pussy is a magic carpet. Harry Pussy is a magic carpet. Harry Pussy, yeah, you wanna ride it. Harry Pussy is a magic carpet. Harry Pussy, who they? Yeah, they know they wanna motherfucker ride it.
I'm digging the whole sex positive, enjoy who you are vibe. When you do your music and you stand back a little, what is your thoughts of, what you're putting out? Are you going for the kill with the joke, or are you going a little about, okay, we're doing, body positive, sex positive messages?
Oh, yes. It's definitely body motivation, self-esteem motivation, self-esteem building, where I just want everyone to know, hey, you got to be proud of yourself, be proud of your vagina, be proud of your sex life. And then in the background, it is a thing where it's a lot of motivation. So it's funny, but my every song has an underlying motivational excerpt to it. Like it's a Persian rug. Some people like to have hairy carpets, hairy pussy. So I want them to be very, confident about it, And I just have different songs that boost confidence. And it's funny as ever, but when you think about it, it's like, hey, who cares? very pussy. It's a magic carpet. I love it. The people love it as well. It's pretty funny because I tell everyone in the shows that the hairy pussies to the front and the bald pussies have to go to the back. So, you know, there's several women that are like, hey, I shaved mine. I'm going to the back of the club. So, you know, it's pretty cool when that song comes on. Audience participation is the funniest.
It's funny because I saw porn and now that's a fetish porn. I mean, that's everyone, guys. You may be totally into like a whole new wave of bringing the Persian rug back into, you know, to the consciousness of America.
Right, right.
You don't get any credit for that either. You got the song, but you're not getting credit for it.
Nope, I'm not getting credit. I need to reach out to Pornhub and tell them to put me on their soundtrack.
Okay, so you have a house party attached to your visit here in July. So you have the show on Sunday, and you're here over the weekend. What's going on? Is this clothing optional? Is this an orgy? Or what are you talking about?
Oh, no, it's not an orgy. It's just a bunch of ladies, and we're twerking, and I have a private chef, and more twerking and having fun. It's like a twerk retreat where, you know, we're all in the house just turning up, having fun, enjoying ourselves, and twerking.
Are you going to go live on any of that as like a live feed in Baltimore that people can see the what's going on in the party atmosphere?
Yeah, I typically go live at the retreat houses, definitely. I have people that join my comedy club, and that is promo for more people to want to join to see the types of things that we do.
You know, your body is actually very tight, and I don't know what your age is, but you're looking good, and you are working out really hard, and I think it's great that you're bringing comedy and being very physical at the same time. It's bringing people off the couch and you know, up to dance, and to, I'm kind of wondering if you thought maybe of doing some kind of, like, a side project, or maybe doing, like, aerobics or fun aerobics.
Right, right. I was definitely thinking of rolling that out in 2020, having some comedy twerkonomics. I call it twerk sessionals, twerk boot camp type of DVDs, where I'll have them come out, and you know, we'll have people that'll be able to have them and use them at home at their leisure. So I was excited about that.
I actually see it. I see it. I mean, you're doing it now. You might as well just make it more organized.
Right. She likes to find it all the time.
Yeah. Now, I did the intro earlier, and I said you're very much like Eddie Murphy. You both are comedians. You both put out music as artists, I said, but the only thing that's different is that your music is awesome and his was not. Who do you have with you that's doing all this work with you?
Oh, I do it all myself. I find the instrumental beat. I come up with the jingles on my own. A lot of it I come up with on the fly. Like I freestyle it as I'm listening to the beat during the shows, and I once someone likes the song, like I'll post the song, and if a lot of people like, hey, I love that song, then I'll go and record it, and I just record at a studio, this nearest studio to me, and get it mastered, and I put it out on the iTunes myself. I do everything all on my own.
With your comedy, you're doing, I mean, most comedians just do 20 minutes, and, you know, and then they're out the door. And that's long, really, for them. And you're on two times a day, you know. I would say that your live show, like your live, that you know, your sets that you're doing each day, you're working new material every day. You're creating new bits. You're doing really brand new stuff. I think that's a lot of creativity.
Right. Every day I'm doing two shows for an hour, and the shows are typically, I come up with a new song every night. So with that, it's a new jingle every night. It's a new theme every night. So like Mondays, I have movie night. So that's going to be some type of movie I'm emulating, and I might be a character and say I'm a sailor and I did Gilligan's Island. I may just do a song that's about a sailboat or my pussy being as wet as a boat or something like that. And then I, you know, go on to the next day, and every day I come up with some type of character, some type of song that's related to it.
You know, it just reminds me, just you talking about your pussy. Do you have a lot of guys who are like lusting over you and want to get a view of this pussy?
No, actually, I don't actually get that many guys that join my comedy club. I have over 2,200. About 90% of them are women. So with that, it's only a handful of men, probably I'd say about 60 men that are even in my group. And they're all, you know, married or respectable. So they understand that it's a character and it's all for fun. But as far as like guys in my DM and stuff like that, I do get the guys, but, you know, it's not, I don't think it's as much as other women would get. I'm not sure, but, you know, of course everybody wants to do something, but I was surprised that I didn't get that many guys that would want to actually be a part of the group, you know. Let's go. You could get into the future.
I noticed that you got a GoFundMe on your website. You're at 10,000. You got Raven Simone, who just donated, and that's really cool. That was just recent. You're close. You're at 7,500, but you're not there yet. And what are you doing with that money once you get it?
Oh, well, that's a way to join my comedy club. It's $12 one time for the year. I add you to my private group, and that is my way of tracking how many people are in different cities. And the goal is, I tell everyone, hey, once I get to 50 people in your city, I come out to your city and do an actual show, like Baltimore. Baltimore has got 50 people that were in the group. That's why I'm coming to Baltimore. So you join the comedy club at $12, and that's just the way to join. I go through GoFundMe, PayPal, and Cash App. So that's just that's actually my paycheck. So I'm able to draw off of it.
I do have fan questions. We reached out to the fans. I have three questions that fans asked. And I looked at them, and I don't know if they're disrespectful or not, but one wants to know if you're having a beef with another internet comedian named Granny.
No. I'm not beefing with any internet comedians. I do a lot of roasts. However, I think that's a young lady that thinks that I copy her or something like that. I don't know. There's been lots of talk about it. People send me stuff about her, but I've never talked to the young lady. I don't know the young lady. So I'm not sure what problem she has with me. But I think she takes what I say as face value. She thinks that I'm a real crackhead. And so, you know, she's beefing with Auntie Hammy, but she's not beefing with Nicole. So we'll put it at that.
The other part is, do you have 360 wigs?
Do I have 360 wigs?
Yeah. Now, being an older white guy, I don't really fully understand what that means. I think a wig, if it's 360, like you can move it to any direction and it would fit the front. Is that what a 360 wig is?
Right. Okay. Well, the 360 wig, okay, it's a joke that I have where I take my wig and I turn it different ways. I slide it to the right slightly, and then I say, oh, it's a whole nother look. It's a whole nother wig look. Now, there is a such thing as 360 wigs, and they cost quite a bit, and that's what a lot of the stars wear. And so, you know, by me saying, oh, yeah, I got on a 360 wig, people are like, oh, where? And I twist it around, and then it's a good joke in that way. So yeah, I do have 360 wigs. All of my wigs are 360 wigs.
You know, that's another marketing I see you can go into. You can have Auntie Hammy's own 360 wig brand.
Right.
there's always opportunities here. Now, the last question that a fan asked, are you focused on supporting Black businesses?
Yes. I call it Black Gannic retreats and Black Gannic trips that I take. What it is, with my retreats, I'm able to go through Airbnb. So I'm able to choose Black-owned Airbnbs for us to stay in to support Black-owned businesses, as well as we visit Black-owned restaurants that are in the area. So when I go and visit Baltimore, I'll be looking for a few Black-owned restaurants to support. Especially when I visit a town for the first time. So I try to give back to the community in that way by purposely supporting Black-owned businesses. We do mukbangs as well. So, you know, we can do them at Black-owned businesses. And all businesses is how I support all businesses with a mukbang.
Seems to me that It's a 22 came out about a year ago, and you definitely have enough songs for another album. It seems like you have enough. What is the next steps? What's next for you?
Well, I will be coming out with the winter album. I'm branding my Ham Shop Fam. So I started a music department where as I record songs, I'll have the different members of the Ham Shop Fam do different things, whether they harmonize, whether we sing choruses together or what have you. I'm going to have it where I brand the whole entire group, not just myself.
Thank you, Auntie Hammy, for joining me on Something Came From Baltimore.
All right. Thank you so much for having me. I love your show. Keep up the good work.
Thank you very much.
Stepping like you cute, stepping like you got some new shoes. Stepping like you Judge Judy. Stepping like you got a big booty. Stepping. We stepping and stepping and stepping it.
Something came from Baltimore. Something came from Baltimore.